One of the things that is worth noting is that every believer have eternal life. They are not trying to have eternal life. So God hears them when they pray. They don't need to repeat prayers or have any doubt. Let me read 1 John chapter 13 to 14. It says, "These things have I written unto you that believe on the name of the Son of God, that ye may know that ye have eternal life." Remarkable, that ye may know that you have it. You are not going to have it, you have it. You have it the split second that you got saved, the Bible way. Verse 14, "And this is the confidence that we have in him, that if we ask anything according to his will, he heareth us. And if we know that he heareth us, whatsoever we ask, we know that we have the petitions that we desire of him." That's why it's very important to pray according to the will of God, not according to your will, not according to a church denomination will or how they pray, but the will that is expressed in the Bible. Let me take the Amplified Translation and you see what's going on. In Amplified Translation, 1 John chapter 5, I'll read verse 14 to 15. It says, "This is the remarkable degree of confidence which we as believers are entitled to." I like that. We are entitled to something great. It says, "To have before him, that if we ask anything according to his will," in other words, that is consistent with his plan and purpose, "he hears us." That is what you want to do, to pray according to the plan and purpose of God. And you can only find that by being a friend of the Word of God. You have to receive the Word of God and accept the Word of God over any non-denominational or denominational doctrine that you're given to. Verse 15 says, "And if we know for a fact, as indeed we do, that he hears and listens to us in whatever we ask, we also know with settled and absolute knowledge that we have granted to us the request which we have asked from him." Isn't that wonderful? When you ask God for anything, the fact that you have not seen the result doesn't mean God has not given it to you. God will give it to you at his time and in the perfect way. When you look at the words used here, the word confident, the Greek word is paresia, that is without ambiguity or circumcision, circumlation or something like that. So without ambiguity, God hears us. Ask, the Greek word is eltio, that means to call for, to crave, to desire, to require. Now, in other words, we know that he has, hears us. The Greek word is eido, it means to get knowledge of, or understand, or perceive. That God hears us, the Greek word is akouio, that means to attend to consider what it is or has been said. So it is the prayer of faith that gets results. That is where our confidence is. That's why it's good to get saved the Bible way. If you don't know Jesus, come to Jesus today, get saved, so that you have that eternal life. And that's what makes God to hear your prayer. Glory to God. So you hear people say, "Do it, Lord, do it, Lord, do it, Lord," repeating prayers. No, as a believer, you don't need to be repeating your prayers or be loud or be, you know, showing off. Just pray secretly and God hears you. And that's the confidence.